Good morning, Sharon Graves here in my art studio. And today I'm going to show you how to set up an acrylic palette. Now I use a Stay Wet box, okay? It's a mess, I know, it's okay. I've been using it for 20 years, and so it might be a little expensive to get started, but you're going to use it forever. It does not come with this sponge, and so you need to purchase that separately, but this is either maybe the third sponge, but I think it's actually only been the second sponge I've ever bought. So they last a long time, and it'll help your paints last a long time. So I'm going to spray the sponge, just water, just trying to get it good. And you can, when you first get your sponge, put it in the sink and, you know, wet it down really good and then wring it out. You don't want it sopping. Okay, the next thing I use, okay, I don't buy palette paper. I'm sorry, I'm cheaper than that. But I buy freezer paper, and it's shiny on one side, very slick, and it's pretty matte color on the, or feel on the other. So I just cut it to fit the box. Push it down in the corners. Okay, so there is that. Now I have three folded up pieces of paper toweling. It's just one of those small ones folded in thirds. And I'm going to put it up one side and then across the top. It'd be nice if you only needed two, because you end up with a little piece there that kind of is goobered up. But and what I mean by that is they're sitting on top of each other right here, okay? But you have to have three because it's not long enough. So then I'm going to wet down the paper toweling, and just damply, okay, just a little bit of spray there on the palette. Okay, so now I lay out my palette. I lay my colors out the same way every single time. My hand and my brush know exactly where to go. Okay, so this is my white, and it's got this small lid. I already loosened it up with this because sometimes it's like wrestling a bear trying to get those off. My white goes all the way over here in the corner, away from everything else. I'm going to use a lot of it. I put a lot of it down, and so that's it on the white. Now I'm going to start on the left-hand side with my colors, and I'm starting with cad yellow, and this is a medium. Okay, so I go all my warm colors, lightest to darkest, and then I start my cool colors. Okay, so here goes the yellow. And now my next color is cad orange, and again, it's from a tube that has that little lid, so I have to use these to open up that small lid. My hands are too stiff, too sore, too old, and I can't get them open. So next comes the cad orange, and sometimes it's almost as hard to get the lid back on as it is to get it off. Cad red light. And again, these are all my warm colors. And now, Hooker's green. Goes in there. Because I'm going light to dark. These are the warm colors, light to dark. Now this is a burnt sienna, burnt umber, and now comes the, I'm going to start the cool colors. That burnt umber is kind of on the verge, but not exactly. This is ultramarine blue, and it's going to go up there in that corner. Okay. It's going to go up here in this corner, and the cool colors are going to come across this way. So there goes the blue. I use quite a bit of blue, so I add a little more of that maybe than some of my other things. This is dioxazin purple. It's going to go in that one little place where the paper towels kind of didn't quite meet each other. Next is turquoise deep, and this is one of those colors where a little goes a long way, so I don't put too much on there. I use it a lot, but I don't... Ugh, man, I didn't think of... This is a lime green, and I know you might think this is warm, but it's not. It's a cool color. And I love it, and when I first started using it, I thought, I'm not sure about this, but I absolutely love it. Okay, so finally, alizarin crimson. Now, any red will go a very long way, so again, you don't need a ton of this. Now, I have a little bit of a space, a little gap between the alizarin crimson and the white. And if I wanted to add some other colors to my palette, I could easily do that there. So, but that's my basic everyday palette. That's how I work. And again, you've got, I have to hold this up here. You've got warm up to here, cool over to here, light to dark. And I really... suggest, and I can't emphasize enough, that you use good student grade artist paint, not a craft paint. You will not get the results that you want from a craft paint when you're trying to, you know, create a painting. And I would also suggest that you, even if you don't have a box like this, lay your a piece of freezer paper on your table. You can lay it out the same way and then just wad it up and throw it away when you're done. Now, when you're done with this, the lid goes on the box. I always spray my paints off just before I close it up, but the lid goes on the box. Make sure it's fit on there good, and your paints will last in there. I use that same palette set up sometimes for a month. And I just keep adding more paint to it. My palette top is a mess, but it works for me. So if you have to have it clean all the time, then the box is still a good way to go, but you might want to change it more often than what I do. So have a great day, and I hope this has helped you. And again, Sharon Graves, Painting with Acrylics, 101.com. Have a good one.